And something. If this earthly house, we have a natural house that we all live in. When we go inside, it's not so clear, not so bright. The light is limited. And we are limited in what we can do and inside. Our body is the temple of God. It is a house. And it's a temporary house. Sooner or later, this body, this house, will be dissolved. Will be destroyed. Will be consumed. There will be nothing left. It will be like dust to dust and ashes to ashes. But Paul is saying, if we are only here temporarily, this is a home of the soul. If this house, this earthly house of this tabernacle be dissolved, we have a building, a house made with, not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. We have our home. So when this body goes, you know, sometimes you get a bit of your home. I don't feel it. Our house. made Adam and Eve, he put them in the garden. And they were in the garden. And he told Adam not to eat of a certain fruit in the garden. And the serpent beguiled Eve and tempted her. And Eve ate the fruit. And she ate the fruit and come and give it to Adam. And Adam ate the fruit. And after they ate the fruit, they found they were naked. So where did nakedness come from? Nakedness came from disobedience. And that's why we have to serve God and obey and be obedient to God. And once we are obedient to God, we are clothed in the righteousness, which is the word of God. We are covered. So we don't need to be feared. We have a confidence. We know. I know. Pastor Scott knows. Every one of us know that if this earthly house be dissolved, we have a house. We have a house. We have a home. That's why we have to serve God. We are in this world, but we're not of this world. We can't follow everything the world does, and we can't agree with everything the world does. The world has a different agenda than we children of God. What is our agenda? Our agenda is to serve God and keep His commandments. Love each other. Let peace, let joy. Let's walk in the Spirit. If we walk in the Spirit, we will not fulfill the lust of the flesh, as the Bible says. Many are dwindling and wavering and halfway in and halfway out. But the Bible says, I would that you were hot or cold, but because you are lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth. So we have to be assertive. We have to know what we are all about. We come to the house of the Lord, we worship God, we praise God, we sing, we clap, we glorify God. We must have the assurance. If this earthly house be dissolved, therefore, knowing that if this earthly house be dissolved, we have a house, a home, made with our hands, eternal in heaven. Should we fear? Should we fear? And what should we fear? What should we fear if we know? Should we fear death? Should there be an obstacle to us? We earnestly desire. You see, the thing is that sometimes we need to tread. The Bible says if we've been wisdom is Christ, set our affection and things on high. We need to think more about heaven than earth. That's what it means. Our thoughts must be more about God than earth. That what's going on down here, we must think more about heaven, where we're going and where we are. children. The apostles, they all died a terrible death. But they were not afraid. They did not deny Jesus. And what is coming up on us now? Can you find me, Sister Blanche? Jeremiah chapter 12, verse 5. What is coming up on us now? What is coming up on us now? What is coming up? We think we've seen everything. What is coming up? We are the church of the living power. Jeremiah 12, verse 5. We are the church of the living God. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. Jesus says, since John, the kingdom of God suffer force, suffer violence, and the violence take it by force. Jeremiah. So he said, if thou hast run with the footman and the weary youth, if thou hast run with the footman, walking, and you're tired, you run with the footman, and they have wearied thee, then how can thou contend with the horseman? I'm just saying, but we don't see nothing yet. We don't see nothing yet. Because Jesus himself said that they will come. When that time comes, there will be so much trouble in the world, not as ever been since the world was created up until this time. Jesus warned us that what is going to happen to this world has never happened before. The flood in Noah's time. Sodom and Gomorrah and the brimstone and fire that occurred is nothing to compare what is to come. So that means brethren must be steadfast. We can't limp in. We're walking now. The horseman is coming. We have to catch up with the horseman. And we have to move faster. So if we can't walk with the footman, how can we walk with the horseman? How can we walk with the horseman? We don't see trouble yet. We don't witness trouble yet. I think it was Sister Johnson also put up something on the WhatsApp. And said that they are going to pass a law in the United States where you can't talk anything about male and female anymore from the gender. And the church cannot speak anything about male and female. The church is going to be persecuted. The church is going to be persecuted beyond measure. There's a bill that they put in before Congress. So basically, if you have a church, you have to have one toilet for men and women. You have one change room for men and women, and you can't distinguish them together. That is what they are planning, the church. It's all about the church. It's all about the church. So we need to be firm. We have to be able to walk with footmen, and not get tired. We have to be able to walk with the footmen there. We have to be able to can take what is going on now and listen with us from and say, thus saith the Lord. The disciples, the apostles, they did not afraid to say, thus saith the Lord. They did not compromise. The problem right now with the church is compromising and we're not coming together. You know? Compromise. We cannot compromise. God does not compromise. So brethren, let us realize that better days are coming, but remember, we have to stand. later, they're going to die. And they knew that God has prepared a place for them, a house for them. So it says in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 9, by faith, Abraham sojourned in the land of promise as in a strange country. We're in a strange country. Dwelling in tabernacle with Isaac and Jacob. Here are the same promise. For they look for a city which has foundation, whose builder and maker is God. We have to look for a city. We are here because we look for a city. peace. Because I have everything I want. I have everything I want. We can't say in these days, so take my peace. We have to be on the battlefield. We have to be on the battlefield for the Lord. You know, we sing that song, I'm on the battlefield for the Lord. And we have to say the meaning. Because when the fire gets rough, when the fire is hot, and the water gets deep, we have to be able to fight and swim and come out. We have to be able to come out of it. We have to come back. We have to trust God that God will deliver. God will always deliver. God never fails. So what is it? We are on this content that while we are in the body, we are absent from the Lord. We are absent. While we are in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk not by faith, we walk by faith, not by sight. And we are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and present with the Lord. When we are present with the Lord, we have peace. When we are present with the Lord, we have an assurance. When we are present with the Lord, we have confidence. When we are present with the Lord, fear cannot come upon us. No circumstances can come upon us. Because we are present with the Lord. And the psalmist said, in the presence of the Lord, the fullness of joy. So if we stay in the presence of the Lord will keep us. He said, will keep those in perfect peace whose minds are stayed on. But you will be blessed. We are blessed beyond measure. And all we need to do is give God the praise and give him the glory. Lift him up. He's worthy. You know, this is so great that Pastor Scott has given this church open. Because I have to be in the house of the Lord. I missed all last week. But I love to be in this house of God. Because I know that in the house of God is the presence of God. Hallelujah. I know that. know I want to do overtime. Nobody don't want to do overtime. Think of. Nobody don't want to do overtime. But we have to do overtime. Because I want a little extra. When I get up there, I want a little extra. So I want to do some overtime. Overtime for God. And then it says, knowing that. We all have one destiny. We should have said, I can't be it. God bless you, my brother. Softly and tenderly,
Jesus is calling.
Thank you. confidence in Him is your confidence. And the Bible says you must come boldly to the throne of grace. Come with confidence, assurance. That's no matter what happens. That's no matter how sick you feel. Satan will try to tell you, say, you're not supposed to be sick.
Right.
Evil is on you. Not evil is on you. He would like to put evil on you. But the word of God is telling us that this tabernacle we will be groaning.
That's right.
We will be having fear,
yes.
Sorrow,
yes.
Trouble.
Yes.
But we have one. It is eternal in heaven. And by the grace of God, we're going to make you one.
Your presence,
Lord.